Good morning, SBC family. Thank you so much for tuning in this morning to be with us. We thank you for your prayers, and we just ask you to continue to love on one another in this time that we have found ourselves in. We know that God is able to see us through. He has brought us to this place, and I know that He is more than capable of seeing us through. So we just solicit your prayers. Make sure that we check on one another. Keep your pastor lifted up in prayer as he continues to minister. And we just thank you for all of your tuning in to all of the different classes that we have and all of the different things that we've been able to put on Zoom. We thank God so much for that ministry as it continues to bless lives and show us that even though we're not gathered together in the building, we're gathered still together in Jesus. So we just worship God, and we just thank you and ask you to come in today and worship the Lord with us as we give him all the praise, because as you well know, he is truly worthy. I ask you at this time to join me in just a short word of prayer before we begin our message. Father, my prayer today is that you would just utilize me, your servant, to be a blessing to your people. Touch somebody's heart. Those who have accepted you as the Lord and Savior, we ask that you reinvigorate us, Lord. And those who might not have accepted you, Lord, we just ask you to touch their heart so that they might receive you and know the blessing of a relationship with an almighty God. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. There's so much going on in the world today. So many things that's happening all over this world. As you know, we are in the midst still of this COVID-19. This is something that a year ago, none of us even knew anything about. Now we've been involved in it for some almost 8 months. It has taken over 200,000 lives. As we think about all of the things that are happening, we had fires that were burning in California, and we've had hurricanes coming in and in the South, and people are dealing with so much stuff. There's so much to consume our thoughts. So many things that occupy our minds, and that's not even talking about our everyday things. Things that we have to deal with on a day-to-day basis of being a family or being a husband or wife or being a child and all of the things that we have to endure, all the things that we have to go through, all of the things that's pulling at our minds and that's vying for our attention. In a time like this, it's no wonder people are distracted. But today I want to talk to you a little bit about what's on your mind. That's my question to you today. What's on your mind? So many things are happening. So many things are going on. We're in the midst of a election year, and we got all of the things that's going on. Every time you turn on the television, there's something talking about one of the candidates that are running, and we got all of these things happening. We got marches and protests. We've got Black Lives Matter, and we've got all kinds of things that just boggle the mind. It's all vying for our attention. So what's on your mind? What Who could blame you for being distracted with all of the things that we have going on? But as children of God, I want to solicit to you that there is something that ought to be on our minds. And that's what we want to talk about today. I want to talk about three benefits of a mind stayed on Jesus. Three benefits of a mind stayed on the Lord. We're going to look at three scriptures. The first being the Old Testament scripture in Isaiah 26:26-3. You'll find there familiar words. And I'm reading from the New King James, rather, version. And you read these words in verse 3. It says, "You will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you, because he trusts you." And the first benefit of a mind stayed on Jesus that I want to talk about is the benefit of peace. This word that we have recorded in the book of Isaiah is actually the words of a song. Isaiah was given a future view of what the church would look like. And in that day, he says that this song will be sung in the land of Judah. It says, "We have a strong city, and God will appoint salvation for walls and bulwarks and open the gates that the righteous nation, which keeps the truth, may enter in." And he says to us, "You will keep us." And when he says "you," he's talking about God. God will keep in perfect peace those whose mind is stayed on him. And that expression translated perfect peace in the Hebrew is literally the word peace, peace. Now, when you look at the scripture, when you find that the word of God repeats itself, that's when you should take a special notice. Isaiah says that those who place their mind and their thoughts in him will be kept in perfect peace. Now, you have to understand that when we talk about peace, we're not talking about the world's peace. We're not talking about peace as it relates to the absence of trouble. But we're talking about peace in the midst of turmoil. If you remember, there's a story in the fourth chapter of the Gospel according to Mark, verses 35 through 41. Look them up when you get a chance then. There's a story of Jesus and his disciples. And Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us go over to the other side." But between where they were and the other side was a storm. And as they were going across the sea, and the wind came up all of a sudden, and the waves began to come into the boat, until these experienced fishermen, who were used to being out on the water, but this storm was something special, and it caused them to be afraid. The Bible tells us that Jesus was in the boat, resting. And the disciples came and woke him and said, "Lord, carest thou not that we are perishing?" The Bible tells us that Jesus got up and he rebuked the wind. And he said, "Peace, be still." Just as Jesus said, the water became calm and the wind ceased. And the disciples were left in amazement. They said to themselves, "What manner of man is this?" Well, what I'm saying to you is that in this life, we're going to have some issues. We're not going to be able to avoid conflict. We're not going to be able to get around trouble. But we don't have to panic, because Jesus is with us. Emmanuel, God is with the child of God. So even though we're in the midst of trouble, even though there's things that are going on in our lives that we have no control over, even though sometimes you might feel helpless, sometimes you might feel like you don't have a handle on this thing, but just don't panic yet, because if you put your trust in God, if you commit your life to him, if you make him a part of your daily thoughts, he can speak to your situation. He can speak to your trouble. He can speak to your dilemma. There's nothing that's too hard for our God. If you want perpetual peace, you should keep your mind stayed on the Lord. The second thing that I want to bring to your attention as a benefit of a mind stayed on Jesus can be found in the fourth chapter of the book of Philippians, starting with verses 6 and 7. The second benefit is the benefit of protection. Paul in the book of Philippians writes, "Be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus." Paul exhorts the Philippians to pray about their circumstances instead of worrying over them. Paul says that we should make our requests known. If you're worried about something, you need to take it to Jesus. Paul uses a military term when he says we'll guard, which implies that the mind is a battle zone and needs to be protected by a military guard. Now, since the purpose of such a guard is to, in a wartime situation, is either to prevent a hostile invasion or to keep the inhabitants of a seized city from escaping, The peace of God operates in that same way. The peace of God protects our mind from external corrupting influences and keeps it focused on God's truth. If you need protection, and believe me, you do, because I don't know if you heard or not, but there's an enemy called Satan. And the Bible tells us that he's like a roaring lion going to and fro in the world, looking for somebody to devour. And a mind stayed on Jesus is a mind that's divinely protected. It's a mind that has God's protection. If you are looking for protection, it's in the word of God. It doesn't matter what your situation is. It doesn't matter what your diagnosis might be. It doesn't matter what anybody says about your situation. If you put your trust in the Lord, He is able to see you through. So the second thing, the second benefit of a mind stayed on Jesus is protection. The third benefit that I want to mention to you can be found in the book of Psalms. In the first chapter of that book, and that benefit is the benefit of provision. The book of Psalms reads thusly, starting at verse 1. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord. And in his law does he meditate day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. Instead of the enjoyment of entanglement with the wicked, the godly person finds enjoyment in the things of God, and in particular, the word of God. Happy is that man whose delight is not in the company of sinners, but whose delight is in the word of God. He says that in his word, he meditates on it day and night. The word meditates means to mumble or to speak to oneself. Now, naturally, we wouldn't promote speaking to yourself because people might get the wrong impression. But when it comes to the word of God, it's all right to talk to yourself. It's all right because you're never alone. to mumble or to speak to oneself, to ponder or to study the word. For the godly man, his delight ought be in the word of God, in what God has said in his word. This tree, the Bible says, is like a tree that's planted by the rivers of water. This tree, which is representative of a Christian, this tree has everything that is required to bring forth its fruit in the season. When you think about a mind stayed on Jesus, it has everything that it needs to live a life pleasing unto God. A mind stayed on Jesus is going to bring forth its fruit, and it's going to bless whomever partakes of it. A mind stayed on Jesus has everything. Everything about that mind is valuable. Now see, don't misunderstand what the psalmist is saying. He says, whatever he does shall prosper. And I don't want you to get the wrong opinion of that, because that's not talking about prosperity in the sense of finances. But it's talking about the fact that you are valuable in the eyes of God. When you have a mind that is stayed on the Lord, you can be a productive Christian. See, I don't know if you know it, but one of the things that the enemy would like to do, now that you got away, now that you gave God your life, one of the things that he wants to do is he wants to make you ineffective. God's desire for us is that we produce fruit. So the enemy wars against us to try to keep us from fulfilling our destiny in Christ. But if your mind is stayed on the Lord, if you're able to keep God in your thoughts, if you're able to keep him in your life, if you're able to carve out some time in the midst of all that's going on to get in your word and study God's word and let God's word minister to you. See, in this word is life. In this word is everything that you need in order to get from earth to glory. In this word is everything you need in order to bless somebody here on this side of the Jordan. But you got to have a mind that stayed on Jesus. This world is going to continue to pull at your thoughts. It's going to continue to seek your allegiance. It's going to continue to try to divert you from that which would make you a blessed individual. But we have to have a mindset that no matter what comes, no matter what life brings our way, because if you don't understand this, you have to, look, life takes us sometimes places that we wasn't planning to go. But I always want you to understand one thing. If you have placed your trust in the Lord, it doesn't make a difference where life takes you, because you're never alone. Everywhere you go, God goes with you. These three benefits of a mind whose thoughts are on God are just a portion This is not an exclusive list, but these are just three things that were brought to my attention in the Lord. But I want you to go back with me to Philippians again as we see what the Lord says as it relates to the kind of things that should be on our mind. Paul in verse 8 of chapter 4 of Philippians pins these words. He says, finally, brethren, whatever things are true, whatever things are noble, whatever things are just, whatever things are pure, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are of good report, if there is any virtue, and if there is anything praiseworthy, he says to us, meditate on these things. Ponder these things. Paul again says to the Philippians to deliberate, to evaluate, to compute over and over what is good and what is pure. When I think about what is good and what is pure, only one name comes to mind. That name is Jesus. I remember as a young fella growing up, I used to hear my mom in the kitchen as she was doing her chores. And I remember how she used to talk to herself, how she used to mumble. And as a young guy, I didn't understand who Ma was talking to. And I dared not ask, because I knew better than that. But I heard her moaning and groaning. I didn't know at the time, but my mother had a serious case of gum disease, and she was constantly in pain. And she would deal with her pain talking to her father. We couldn't afford to go to the dentist and have all that dentistry work done. So she had to endure the pain. But she just mumbled and talked to the Lord. As I grew up, I began to understand a little bit better what Mama's going through. No, I can't feel that pain, but now at this point in life, I know what pain is. I know how it feels to have a situation that you don't know the outcome. I know how it feels to have trouble in my life. Sometimes I find myself like Mama, moaning to myself, talking to my father. I invite you today that if you don't know him, you ought to get to know him. And if you do know him, whatever you do, have a little talk with the Lord. And tell him all about your troubles. The Bible tells me that he cares for me. He has invited me to cast my cares upon him, because he loves me more than I could ever know. A mind stayed on Jesus is a dangerous thing. Because it means that you're focused. It means that you're determined. It means that you know where your help comes from. It means that you're not going to give up when the going gets tough. It means that you know the source of your strength. And let me tell you something, I don't care what this life throws at it, as long as Jesus is in the boat with me, as long as I know that he has my best interest in mind, as long as I know that he won't leave me nor forsake me, I believe that I'll be able to make it through. I believe that I can keep putting one foot in front of another until I get to where God wants me to be, because I know how faithful that he is. When I think about the name of Jesus, I think about his love. I think about his forgiveness. I think about his faithfulness. I think about his mercy. I think about his patience with me. I think about how good he is toward us. You need a mind stayed on Jesus. I realize now why the writer said, my soul cries out. My soul cries out. Thank you, Lord, for all that you've done for me. What's on your mind? What's on your mind, brothers and sisters? The world is going to continue to try to get you off your square. The world is going to continue to do what it does. But I hear the words of God saying, fear not, children. I have overcome the world. And because he overcome the world, because he lived, the song says, I can face tomorrow. Brothers and sisters, let us keep our minds on God. Now, let me tell you this. In order to keep your mind on God, you're going to have to be intentional. This is not going to be something that happens by chance. You're going to have to make a conscious effort to keep your mind on him. Because it's easy to get distracted in a time like this. But God wants us to know that no matter what we go through, no matter what hand we're dealt in this life, that he is with us. That he won't leave us. That he won't forsake us. I'm not saying to you that there won't be pain. I'm not saying to you that there won't be heartache. I'm not saying to you that everything is going to fall into place. But what I am saying is that we serve a God that is able to deliver us, that is able to walk through the valley with us, that won't desert us, no matter how rough the trail gets. But you got to keep your mind stayed on him. What's on your mind? What do you allow to enter your thoughts? What do you allow to take up your time? In this world, we are bombarded on every side. You can't turn on the television. You can't go outside. You can't go inside. You can't go to the mall. Everywhere you go, there's things pulling at your allegiance, trying to take up your time, trying to distract you. But we've got to be a people of purpose, a people on a mission. And that mission is to glorify our Savior. What's on your mind? Let us pray. Father, we thank you for your peace. We thank you for your protection. We thank you for your provision. We know, Lord, that you will keep us in perfect peace. Those whose mind are stayed on you. Help us to focus. Help us to keep the course. When the way gets difficult, Lord, help us to keep our hand in yours, knowing that you will see us through. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you, Lord, for loving a wretch like me. In Jesus' name. Amen. There might be somebody out there today who have not accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. I got good news for you. Today can be your day. Today can be the day that changes your life. All you got to do is confess your sin, ask God to forgive you, and accept Him as your Lord and Savior. If you're willing to do just that, God's hand is outstretched to you right here today. He's willing to save you this day if you'll just put your trust in Him. Mine is a terrible thing to waste. Keep your mind stayed on Him. God bless you.